Chinese tech companies deal this thing with, really? Or is this just a bargaining chip for US and China to negotiate terms? Chinese tech stocks hammered as US law threatens to delist firms from American exchanges as early as in March 2021. What was in the news back then was that certain companies identified by SEC will require auditing by a US watchdog, and if this company do not submit documents and auditing reports to the official watchdog, then they might be suspended for trading. And these companies will also have to name each board member who is a Chinese Communist Party official. Nevertheless, short sellers didn't succeed on first move, with Hang Seng Tech Index hovering around 8,000 points till June 2021. But Chinese tech regulations give then the short sellers the chance to short sell Hang Seng Tech Index as well as the Hong Kong and US listed Chinese tech companies. This is just a series of regulations released since July 2021. Since early October 2021, China has already been releasing signals of softening their stance against tech companies in China. But Hang Seng Tech Futures continue to struggle above 6,000 points, only to be broken as non-Chinese media reported on 1st December 2021 that China is planning to ban the VIE structure. CSRC promptly refuted news as fake news. Nevertheless, Alibaba dropped from $230 from end June 2021 to 52-week low of $108. Baidu also made 52-week low of $133. Same for Pinduoduo. JD also made 52-week low of $61. So the Tiger Brokers, on 24 December 2021, China announced that they are not planning to ban VIE structure. So to address non-serious concerns, what are the options available to Chinese tech companies? So the number one question to ask ourselves is, when will this Holding Foreign Companies Accountable Act be applicable to Chinese tech companies? This is only applicable 3 consecutive years after being identified by the SEC, meaning earliest by March 2024. Knowing the timeline, what are the options available to Chinese tech companies? For those that are already dual listed in Hong Kong and US, it's likely that their ADRs are fungible, meaning that their ADRs can be converted to Hong Kong shares. But what about those Chinese tech companies only listed in US, meaning their shares are not fungible to Hong Kong shares? One scenario that can happen is that their shares will get suspended in 2024. If US and China negotiate this period from 2022 to 2024 and they can't reach a deal on the audit process. Another scenario is for this Chinese tech company listed in US to apply for Hong Kong listing and be dual listed as well, meaning their ADRs will be fungible into Hong Kong shares. Another scenario is for this US tech companies to privatize by their founders and then to buy out existing minority shareholders. To me, it's clearly not the end of the day for Chinese tech companies with US listing because there are so many options available to them. So the number one thing for people who are invested in Chinese tech companies listed in US is to go and dig into the prospectus and see whether the ADRs or ADS that you bought, is it fungible? Investopedia actually say that fungibility is the ability of a good to be interchanged for another individual goods of the same type, meaning ADRs, ADS into Hong Kong shares. This is one material that I extracted from Alibaba depository agent. Inside this notice, they actually mentioned that Alibaba Group shares in Hong Kong will be fully fungible into the ADS listed in US, meaning that they can be fungible into Hong Kong shares or into ADS, vice versa. Baidu did a Hong Kong listing in March 2021 and indicated in their prospectus that their ADS are fully fungible. For ADS or ADRs that are fungible, the short seller's point of view that Chinese tech ADRs are worthless is clearly not true. US and China have 2 years to negotiate from 2022 to 2024 on the audit point, which I believe there's ample time to discuss, just like trade war discussion. Bearing in mind that the next US election is in 2024, China's securities regulator even announced that they are ready to communicate with US counterparts. See here. Even if US and China cannot reach a deal on the audit process, the Chinese tech companies, which currently do not have a Hong Kong listing, can apply for a dual listing in Hong Kong, hence resulting in a fungible ADRs or ADS. Assuming the Chinese tech companies with only US listing do not apply for Hong Kong listing, highly unlikely though, but let's assume that they did this, the board will still be required to seek a delisting offer for existing shareholders at a reasonable price. The question here is whether the Chinese tech company's owners will take advantage of existing minority shareholders and offer them a low delisting offer price. There's this possibility, but it's highly unlikely that these tech companies will want to risk themselves in a negative limelight, thereby drawing attention from CSRC and China. Remember, China cares about what we say face, which is mianzi in China. This is just a recap of the options available to Chinese tech companies given current scenario. I have even grouped that into high risk, low risk, or moderate risk for each of us to think through. As always, this should not be construed as any investment or trading advice.